Ann Coulter joins me now, syndicated columnist and the best-selling author most recently of In Trump We Trust, E Pluribus Awesom. And I guess it would be, wouldn't be overstating it to say that you've been a little disappointed in the candidate that you backed a year ago.
Yes, it's almost Christmas and we don't have a wall yet.
No, but we're doing a whole lot better on border enforcement, and maybe we start to make the point that maybe that undercuts the point about the wall, but I'd stick that. I still want the president to do it, but I'm glad to see that we got the tax cuts because I think it's going to make the economy flow.
Yeah, I think it's like sprucing up the paint job on the Titanic after it's hit the iceberg. It's really not going to save America. We're at the tipping point now. I just saw that moron Republican Cory Gardner being interviewed on Fox News, and you know, he and Dane are just so excited about the tax cuts, and oh yeah, the Democrats are going to run against tax cuts. What do they want to raise taxes? They remember Walter Mondale, and I'm screaming at that TV. That was 30 years ago. That was before you dumped millions upon millions of third worlders on the country who do not care about tax cuts. The very next thing they start talking about is how the Republicans have to pass the DACA, the Dreamer Act. So great, make it absolutely impossible for tax cuts to ever be popular in America again. Immigration solves everything. Immigration is the iceberg. Our country is the Titanic. This is why Trump won, this ridiculous, tacky reality TV star. How about doing something popular, Republicans? Do what? Didn't everyone watch the 2016 campaign? Nobody thought this guy was going anyplace. How did he do it? How did he win the presidency? On the issue of immigration, and they haven't done one thing on it. And in fact, they seem to want to do the exact opposite and just be Bush too. Yep, let's push amnesty because we're Republicans and we want to wreck the country too.
Well, I want to be more optimistic than you are, Ann. You're a friend. I love having you on the show, but I'm frustrated by this too. But I guess I'm saying let's be patient and get to those things, because for a long time we were saying we have to get rid of Obamacare first. And I thought that was a good promise to start with. The wall would have been nice, but the promise on Obamacare. And now in the tax bill, we get rid of one of the most egregious parts of Obamacare, and really the part that's central to its existence. Is it and you didn't hear a lot of hue and cry from the Democrats. They kind of just let that one float on by. And there was the threat, you have to fix DACA before you're going to get the tax cuts. That didn't fly either. So, you know, the caterpillar tractor that is Donald Trump just keeps plowing ahead, and it will eventually get to some of those things, just maybe not in the order or in the timing that we would like.
Well, he's going to get wiped out in the midterms if he hasn't made substantial progress on the wall. In addition to ending the individual mandate, one thing that, yeah, you're right, the Democrats didn't mention this at all, was apparently we will finally be drilling in Anwar.
Yeah.
So there are some great things. I'm delighted they got rid of the state and local tax deduction. We're going to start putting pressure on the high tax states. Their high earners aren't going to be able to deduct that anymore. And you may recall, why was Gray Davis recalled from office, the California governor? Of all the crazy things he was doing, of all the ridiculous pensions he was pushing through, and things that were actually destroying the state of California. No, it was a car tax he imposed. It was like a $30 car tax, and all these young people who weren't paying any taxes, they suddenly blew up and demanded that he be recalled from office. It was the first time in, I don't even remember, either ever or about 100 years, a governor was recalled in the state of California because of some very small car tax. So, you know, maybe in places like my home state of Connecticut, the Democrats will come under pressure to cut taxes now that it can't be deducted federally. But again, we're not when we're pedal to the metal on creating a country where a Republican will never, ever be elected president again. These are all, it's like painting the Titanic. You get some short-term gains, but 20 years from now, you're still living in Mexico.
I'm going to tell you, Ann, I think the wall is going to happen. You know, the prototypes have been built, and you know that some of this is just making these things. You got to get to the point point where you can get enough votes behind it to vote it through. And at this point...
I would like them to hold those votes. I want to know which Republicans need to be primaried. I would like to see the Democrats run on voting against a wall. If Republicans had two IQ points, they would know this is very, very popular. They should talk about nothing but immigration.
Well, how about Flake and McCain for starters?
But... ending anger babies, building the wall. Make the Democrats vote on that. Make them vote on it over and over again. They will be so popular, they'll wonder, why haven't we been doing this for 20 years?
Because they didn't have the guts to do it, did they?
But didn't we all just watch this crazy reality star win the White House? What is it going to take for them to learn this is really popular? You want to be popular, Republicans? Start pushing the immigration stuff.
And to use maybe a strained metaphor, but remember years ago, you and I talked about how Hollywood made movie after movie after movie, you know, that talked about people coming back from the Iraq War and how evil it was and this and that, and they lost their shirts on those movies. And then somebody made one pro-America, pro-patriotism movie, you know, is either Hurt Locker or one of those, and then eventually American Sniper. And Hollywood can look at that and say, yeah, those movies did big box office, but we're going to go right back to making the anti-war movies because that's who we are. In some ways, the establishment Republicans remind me of the decision makers in Hollywood. They'll say, yeah, that worked out really well for Donald Trump, but no, we're not going to follow that model with all our other candidates.
No, because we've done this. It didn't begin with Donald Trump. There was Eric Kander losing his seat and this little known economics professor getting elected.
Hey, Brad.
Oh, yeah, there was Proposition 187 in California. Every time Americans have been able to vote on immigration, every time they have said, please, less.
And in this case, we may get there. In fact, here's what I want to see. You know, as the American economy really pops up and we're headed toward 4% growth, we're already at 3.3 in the third quarter, likely 3.6 in the fourth quarter this year. We could easily be at the impossible, all the economists, you know, the idiot at the New York Times.
Krugman.
Krugman said was impossible.
How I got that right away?
I know, because
the idiot at the New York
Times.
And that isn't an easy one.
No, and Thrush comes in a close second, and he just got suspended. But when you see it hit 4%, you know, that's going to be one of the triggers that will start bringing the illegals trying to come back across the border, because that's what they'll respond to. And when that will put the pressure on to say, well, we're doing good border enforcement, but maybe we do actually need a physical barrier there. And I think that may give the president the authority he needs to go to the Republicans and say, vote for the damn wall that's already in the law.
I know I've said this before, but just in case any of your listeners have missed it, he doesn't need Congress. It would be fun if Congress were smart. They'd get Democrats on the record voting against the wall. He's the commander-in-chief. His job under the Constitution is to protect our borders. He's not going to get away with not building a wall by saying, oh, Congress didn't give me the funds. You're commander-in-chief. Build the wall.
And it's a pleasure to have you on. Have a wonderful Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas, Lars Larson.
Ann Coulter, syndicated columnist and the author most recently of In Trump We Trust, E Pluribus Awesome. You're listening to The Lars Larson Show.